Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and welcome to this version control tutorial. Today, we're taking a look at some of the basic Git commands, Ace. We'll also discuss the concept of checking out and reverting files. I'd advise you to watch my previous Git videos, Ace, as a lot of the topics I'll mention here are discussed in greater detail in them. So let's get started. If you've watched my previous videos, you should already have your project set up locally and connected to a remote repo on one of the Git hosting sites. Here I'm setting up two local Git repositories, Ace, with one of them acting like a remote repo. The remote repository is not like the local clone, Ace, since it doesn't have a working copy of the project checked out. This is called a bare repository. I'll explain this later in the video, Ace. When you set up a remote repository on GitLab or another hosting site, they'll create a bare repository for you. There's no way to create a bare repository in SourceTree, Ace, so I'll have to use the command line. I'll discuss this process in a later video. Now that we have both repositories set up, it's a good idea to check to see if your credentials are correct, Ace. I'll also quickly add the remote's URL to the local repo. With them both linked, we're ready to learn Git, Ace. Let's add a basic file to our local repo. Just a simple text file with a bit of text, Ace. If we head back into SourceTree, you'll see that we have uncommitted changes. If you can't see this, Ace, make sure the log history tab at the bottom is selected. As discussed in a previous video, Git stores several snapshots of the project and creates a new copy of the file if the file is changed. These snapshots are called commits, Ace. Here we have our file that has just been added. Now, in order to commit these changes, we have to stage the files. Currently, the file is in the unstaged area, Ace. Having a staged area allows us to choose which files get committed, allowing us to commit the files that we want or to separate changes with meaningful commits. If we click on the file status tab and type in our commit message, you'll see that our commit button is still grayed out. This is because at least one file needs to be in the staged area in order for us to commit this. You can add each file individually to the staged area by clicking the checkbox beside the file. Clicking the checkbox beside unstaged files will stage all the files in the unstaged area. With our file staged, we can now commit this. Click the commit button. If we click on the local history tab, you'll see our first commit is. It also has a tag beside it indicating where our master branch is in relation to the remote's master branch. Branches are out of the scope of this video, Ace, but since they are such an important concept in Git, I'll continue to mention when they pop up. I'll discuss branches in greater detail in a future video, Ace. Okay, so we've committed our first change, Ace, but this change is only present on our local repository. We now need to sync the changes with our remote. Head back into SourceTree and click the Push button in the top menu. A dialog will pop up and you can choose which branch's changes you want to push, Ace. Currently, we only have the master branch in our Git repository. Click the checkbox under the Push column and click OK. Now our changes have been pushed to the remote repository. We even have a nice tag beside our first commit, indicating that our remote has caught up. Let's add more changes to our project, Ace. Here I'm adding in a new change to the first file and adding in a new file called added file. Back to SourceTree and we have uncommitted files to commit. Here I'll show you selective staging in action, Ace. Click the checkbox beside the file you want to commit and it'll be added to the staged area. Committing only this file means my commit will only have the changes made to the first file. After the commit, I'll still have added file in the unstaged area. Clicking the checkbox beside it will add it to the staged area and will allow us to commit. Now if we head back to the log history tab, we can see that it's all changed. Our two new commits have been added, and beside our master tag, there is an additional tag saying to ahead. This means that our repository is two commits ahead of our current remote repository on the master branch, Ace. It's time for another push to update our remote repository, Ace. Click the push button in the top menu and click OK. Now our remote is updated to the same point as our local repo. Let's discuss the concept of checking out in Git. In Git, you can check out branches, commits, and files, Ace. Here I'm checking out the added to first file commit. I do this by double clicking on the commits line, Ace. Doing this will bring up a warning about creating a detached head. I'll go into more detail about this in a later video, Ace. We can see that the new tag head has been added to the added to first file commit, Ace, and the white dot that was previously on the added file commit has moved down. Head is a pointer to the current checked out commit, Ace. When you check out the commit with the master tag beside it, head refers to the master branch, which points to the most up-to-date commit on that branch. Again, more on this in later videos, yes. Now if we look in the My Project folder, you'll see that add file has disappeared. This is because we have checked out the commit just before it was added, yes. If we check out the commit before that, you'll see that the amendment from first file has disappeared too, yes. This is why version control is so powerful. Make sure you recheck out our master branches commit, yes, since being in a detached head state is not ideal. I'll show you how to revert files in future videos, yes. Let's have a closer look at some other powerful things you can do with Git. Here I'm making changes to my files, yes. The added file will have a good change that I want to keep, and the first file will have a change that I want to get rid of. Back in source tree and we have uncommitted changes. We will commit the added file like before, but we won't commit the first file. Instead, we're going to discard changes made to the first file, yes. Right click on the file, click discard and click OK. This will revert the file back to the previously committed version, yes, and we'll remove it from the staging area. Now our added file has the good change and the first file has been reverted. You can also revert several files at once, yes. Here I'm making changes to both files that I don't want to commit. Head back into source tree and click the discard button in the top menu. We can individually discard the changes to our files or discard all the changes at once, yes. Click on the reset all tab and click the reset all button. This will revert all uncommitted files to our previous versions, yes. This is amazing when you're experimenting with your code, as you can mess up and quickly get the project back to a stable state. Let's look at a remote repository. A bare repository doesn't have a working copy of the code, yes. That is to say that no commit has been checked out in our bare repository. This is why there are no files in the remotes folder. This is just the start, yes, and we'll look at how to pull changes from the remote repo in the next video. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, yes, I hope you're enjoying these Git videos. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com to tell me how you're getting on. Thank you for watching, yes. And I'll see you in the next video.